Texas, which Republicans have won by double digits in 7 of the last 9 elections, is now a toss-up state. The Lone Star State has not won a Democrat presidential candidate since Jimmy Carter beat Gerald Ford in 1976. According to the latest Texas Tribune poll, Donald Trump holds just a 3 percentage point lead over Hillary Clinton. Trump had the support of 45% of likely Texas voters, compared with 42% for Clinton and 7% for Libertarian Gary Johnson. But Texas is home to more than 138,000 Pinoys, one of the largest Filipino populations in the South. Those who we spoke with told us they are voting for Democratic presidential nominee Hillary Clinton.
This year, I'm leaning towards Democrat.
So. Why is that?
I just don't agree with Trump's values, really. Hillary Clinton seems like a better choice. Her stance on education, she's trying to make it more affordable for millennials.
This Texan Phil M. is a registered Republican, but for this election, he chooses neither Trump nor Clinton.
You know, the scandals of Hillary and just the overall disrespect that Trump shows, it's kind of hard to support either of them. I think most of them probably side with me. They don't really support either one, except for the older Filipinos. I think they like Trump more.
Why is that, though?
Just because he's just kind of different than the other candidates we've had in the past. He's, you know, he speaks his mind and he's more direct. He doesn't really politic.
Ramil Argosino, a Phil M. in San Antonio, says that a lot of the Phil M. voters he knows are leaning toward Clinton.
Attitude-wise, like I said, Trump, by the way he manages his campaign, by the way he manages his debates, he's like much more a bully, and he insinuates things and he insults people. Most of my friends are leaning more for Hillary.
Texas is the strongest Republican state in the nation, but for Phil M's, who are registered Republican voters, they say that they are voting for Clinton this November. Bev Lorente, ABS-CBN News, San Antonio, Texas.